here's the shot. It was somewhere, probably, I'm thinking actually more around here.
Didn't have the shed.
Okay. Yeah, back in 1977, we did not have this shed or this extra addition over here. This came later on for storage. And oh my God. Oh my God.
Hey, Vinny, need help?
Oh, no, Gumby, it's fine.
Okie dokie.
Trouble, Mr. Vince?
Oh, no, Major Matt Mason, I'm good, thanks.
Hey, okay.
Well, and now for a new episode of The Best Part.
Don't drink the coffee. If coffee keeps you awake, it won't. Coffee never keeps me awake.
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome back again to the penultimate episode of Vinny G's The Best Part. I'm your host, Vinny G, of course. This is the second to last episode, in case you didn't know exactly what penultimate means. That's what it means. It's the second to the last one of this series. Shorter series. I've been saying that over and over. I'm going to take a couple of months off after the last one. And then we'll see about season two of the first reel. But I probably will do it. But it probably will be my last season doing it. I just kind of, it's hard to find movies, that are free to show and to do the clips and all that without having problems copyright wise. So it gets very difficult. And so maybe I'm thinking maybe doing more TV show stuff. I don't know. I got ideas in my head, just tossing them around. I never come up with anything solid until like literally the last minute. So it doesn't even matter. But anyway, here we are, number 7, and I'm going to do a movie that is so dear to my heart. I got my, in tribute, I have a wheel. Now, one of my favorite rides at Disneyland is Pirates of the Caribbean. In fact, it is the number one ride. It's my favorite ride. Absolutely tops. Nothing else. Even if they make something new that's better, like the Star Wars stuff, I don't care. Pirates is it, man, and I'm going to die saying that, all right? So because of that reason, I really like, and it came out like, I think the Pirates ride opened in 67, I think like a year after Walt died. And it was really the ride that the Imagineers, because they were so close to Walt and so upset that he died, and it was a real tribute. You know, they had already done most of the ride. There's TV shows about it. The Disneyland TV shows. And so you see Walt there with all the mock-ups pretty much complete. And then I'm sure they were starting the, you know, construction or whatever. But anyway, what happens is he dies and they go, let's put this ride up. So they put the ride out, released it in time, within a year or so. And really that's the one ride. I think that when you see it, you can see the heart and soul. You can see, you know, that's Disney's like last real project that was Disney sort of personally stamped and approved by him, right? So it's the classic. It's the ultimate classic. So having said that, with pirates, you know, and that, I love movies about ships. I love movies about crews and pirates and things. I hear noises over there. Anyway, so this movie is a Sinbad movie. And this was from the old Sinbad movies, Ray Harryhausen. Not like Douglas Fairbanks and those guys. I mean, they kind of started it. Swashbucklers is what they called those. But these were really, these were the stop motion stuff. You know, these were the ones that were Ray Harryhausen. He was my hero when I was a kid. I think when I was probably in the third grade or so, maybe even before that. That's what I wanted to do. I was like, I want to be a stop motion animator. He was my hero. He really was. And I dabbled in bits of it, you know, with some films and stuff, but I never could get it fully done. And you know, I didn't have models. He made his own models. You know, he made the creatures himself. He was basically like a modern day sort of, you know, YouTuber or social network person, because, he was just in the room or in the garage or whatever, with his mock-ups and his cameras and everything was all set. And then, you know, he would just go to work, you know, days on end, creating these creatures, step by step, stop motion animation, you know? So you have to articulate the things. And so the Sinbad movies, the first one, which this one is the Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, Kerwin Matthews, who does not look anything like a, you know, an Arab or an Arabic person. He's total white guy, you know, Sinbad, but that's okay. Back then you didn't care. You just went with it. And what happened is the movie would come out on TV, but very rarely. Because it came out, I think, in like 54 or something like that. It was in the 50s. And it's nice color, nice scenery, and actually pretty well directed, you know, for what it is. It's just a schlocky little, you know, a popcorn movie. But the great thing about it, besides Ray Harryhausen, is that it sort of articulates what stop motion animation could be, which was you don't have to have it through the whole movie. Just have your story, drop it in at the right points. And it carries the picture, really, but it does it in very, you know, sparse ways. And this movie, what happened was not hardly being on TV. It was hard to find it. And if it was on, I probably missed it half the time or more because TV Guide wasn't that reliable, or you didn't look at it as closely. And so what they did was they would re-release it every once in a while, and they re-released it for drive-ins, because I think it was because of Golden Voyage of Sinbad had come out in like I almost want to say it was the same year as Star Wars, like 77, 76, 77, 78, maybe. I don't know. I haven't looked up the official, you know, I've seen it, but then I forget. But, so it came out, you know, and then they decided to re-release, Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, this first one, for drive-ins. And then so my parents took me, we went with actually some friends, some neighbors, had like a little drive-in party, and I was surprised they enjoyed it, because I was a little kid, you know, I was like 13, 14 years old or something, and I didn't really, it wasn't something that I didn't think adults would really care about, because I felt like it's old, and to them it's probably old, and you know, it's a kid movie, you know. But they enjoyed it. I always enjoy it. So, Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, I think directed by Charles Schneer, I want to say. There was a group, you know, like people, directors, the big directors like Carpenter and De Palma, they had groups that they worked with, all the same crew and all that. And so that's what happened. There was Charles H. Schneer and Ray Harryhausen. And there was a couple other directors and producers that were always on the credits, you know. So anyway, here it is. And by the way, probably the best part of Seventh Voyage of Sinbad is the skeleton fight. And that comes out almost at the end, so that's why I didn't want to do that. And plus, there's another better, actually, skeleton fight in Jason and the Argonauts, where you have multiple skeletons. So I kind of thought, let's just cancel the skeletons out. At this movie, it comes out, it's kind of the climax, and so I didn't want to spoil that. But this stuff right here is kind of about an hour in, maybe or less, and it's the Cyclops, which was, oh my God, my favorite character, I think, of all time. He just was great with the one eye, the horn, the they didn't say anything about Cyclops having like goat legs or whatever they are, but that's what he had, you know. It's like Harryhausen used to like to mesh mythical creatures, you know, and do things with them. And in Golden Voyage, he had another Cyclops, but it was one of those horse man things. I forget what you call him, Sagittarius guy. But anyway, let's start the clip. And this clip begins at when they're sailing on the seas. Hey. And what happens is there's a curse that the mad wizard is going to invoke on the mutineers, because the Sinbad's crew is mutinying on him. And so he tries to stop him, and the wizard, you know, they can't do it. Him and the wizard are sort of together just for his purposes, the wizards and Sinbad's. And then the crew mutinies, and the guy, the wizard, puts a curse, and you'll see what happens. But then after that, the great Cyclops. Oh, I love the Cyclops. All right, let's start the clip now. Oh, take my glasses off for this so I can see it.
This is a touching show of friendship. Take your sword.
Here he goes. Oh, took his cape.
Here, the magician's cloak will make a flag for us.
See, this is good. This is like pirate stuff, you know. This is why I love it. Got my mind.
Wish for a night of pleasant dreams. Hear my curse, for it seals your doom. Those who harm us shall be driven mad. Terror shall be in your hearts. And before dawn, you will plead with us for your very lives.
Don't fuck with the wizard, man. Don't fuck with a wizard. All right, here goes the headphones.
For you, I will tie the nut myself.
So tie the nut myself.
Slowly.
Oh, that way he falls back. He's going to tie the nut himself. Tie his nuts. You know, these movies used to hire great character actors, you know, just side people that were, you know, just have this little teeny part, but they really go for it, you know. Yeah, that guy, that bald guy was... God, what was his name? Someone say his name was Thor or Tor or something. I don't know. He was a character actor. He was in a lot of stuff. Nice dubbing on that voice, huh? They might as well put Mel Blanc in there, you know. Hey, Doc, are you going to stuff these in our ears? Oh, see, I love these ships. You know, in these old movies, man, they know how to do the miniatures. And they know how to slow it down just right, have the right kind of waves. And most of the time it was just miniatures. I mean, not miniatures like a little thing like this, but miniature as far as, you know, a studio. It was, that probably was like a, you know, four feet long or something, you know. But for the purposes of filming, it's a miniature. Oh, man, so they're going crazy. I guess they're hearing, yeah, there's like a mermaid screams or something. I don't know what it is. Oh, look at that. Oh. See, despite all this misery, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a pirate. That's all. Like, fuck it. Man, look at all that. Like, I can't even imagine in real life where these guys really had to do that, you know? They had to live days on the ocean, not even know if they were going to live. Look at these storms. Ships made of wood, rope, you know. How did we even get to where we are now? I mean, it's amazing. This is just a dumb movie. Oh, shit. Oh. They're going crazy. They're going mad. He's like, he can't stand him yelling, and oh yeah, it's good. And look at, that's all tilting the camera. A lot of this is just in-camera stuff, you know. They're not, it's not a set that's actually moving as far as I know. It's just act this way, act that way. Yeah. You too. Oh, man. There's a lot of death in the... A lot of death in these kid movies, you know what I'm saying? That's why I loved them. They didn't pull punches, man. They're like, yeah, we know a lot of kids are watching. People die! Especially back then when ships are flying around and Cyclops are eating them, you know. The Beast of Colossus. Wow. All that intense and then just... Oh yeah, this is cool. See that backdrop right there? That face, that's a miniature. And then they had to, like I do, green screen, you know, a type of green screen. It was mats, they called it. And it was black on white, I think is the way they did it. So it wasn't green screen, kind of a black screen. And shit. The great crossbow. Look at that giant arrow. See, they're not bullshitting. They're like, if something big comes out of there, we're gonna fucking shoot it with that giant arrow. Yeah. Excuse me. Hmm? What? If one group is captured, oh, yeah. Ah. But actually, he's very devious. He wants to go his own way because he's got his own agenda and he knows what the hell he's doing. Got a secret plan. Sinbad probably is kind of suspicious, but he's going to let him play it out. See, It's like, I don't know about you. And look at that costuming too, just so simple and almost like a high school production costuming with Sinbad anyway. Yeah, these movies, they did okay. You know, they were just trying to get the message across of what it was, where the lands were, and what type of people lived in the lands. And you got your swords and your turbans and big belts with open sleeves and kind of loose pants. And then boots, you know. It's just very, stereotypical, I guess, you know. Look at the embroidery on there. So here's some hill shots, yeah. The Valley of the Cyclops.
You, Gola, do not drink so deeply. Yeah. We will need the water for our climb tomorrow.
Oh, shit.
We can fill the skin from the pool.
No. No good.
Water is poison. Mm. The man who lets it touch his lips will be dead in a moment. Poison?
Probably where the Cyclops pees. Yeah, you want to try it? Go for it. No, I don't think so. Yeah, that's where the Cyclops shits and poops and pees. It's his running toilet water. It's funny. Oh, look at that giant club, huh? Oh. Perfectly clean skeleton. Well, I guess, you know, when you're out in the desert, there's scavengers, bugs, birds. Things have been known to pick bones clean. That's a little too clean, but it's a movie. Oh no, another club. Oh shit. Big chair or something? Or stool? See, this is great. All the practical sets are just fantastic. This is what movies are about, you know, making big things, making little things. And turning them into a whole show. I wonder where they shot this stuff. See, it's probably in America somewhere. Probably in California. But I'm not sure. I don't look these things up. You can look it up if you want. I probably will too later myself, but this is how I like to watch them. Like I was a kid. I just watched the movie. I didn't care about the year and where they were and all that. So yeah, watch out. Where's that Cyclops at, man? Music was good. I want to say it was Bernard Herrmann. Or Miklos Rosa or somebody. There was all these different composers back there. I want to say Bernard Herrmann. Oh, look at that. They found the treasure. It ain't yours. Look at... I was like, oh, shit. Someone's a little femme, huh? Oh. 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 So here's more stunt work. Yeah, the mutiny had a lot of stunts. Had a big fight scene that I cut to after. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, get that guy. Throw him in a cage, Cyclops. Oh man, see when I was a kid, the Cyclops wasn't my enemy. I love the Cyclops. He was my pal, man. It's like, get those motherfuckers. Yeah, get another one. Look at how cool that looks. damn, I wanted to make my own too, you know, but then I wanted to copy him. Being a kid, man, look at this, great. Have him like on a hook or something. Look at that shot. And that's an animated Sinbad right there. Look at that. Great, great design, you know? Just a classic, classic Cyclops face. Look at that. Badass. He didn't even need the club. That was cool. He's gonna roast spit somebody here. Oh. Sorry, your dinner. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh. That's right. Give it to the big dumb guy. Test him out. Here. I think they say it's like wine, too. Watch. That's good. Watch. Hey. Oh, shit. Oh. Oh, he's the guy. Watch. Oh, shit. It's gonna make him crazy, I guess, probably. Oh, wow. Got him tied up. Roast him with his clothes on. That's kind of weird, but I don't know. Maybe he doesn't want a direct flame. It's like all the sweat in the clothes will stay in the meat. Oh, wow. He's right there. Like, what the hell are you guys getting here for? Oh. I'll see. Liar. No, he can't. Not even gonna try. Harufa. Oh yeah, his wiener. No, not his wiener. Yeah, the princess. Just like Star Wars, right? There's a princess in here. And it's, she's literally like a little midget. Remember in Star Wars, it was like a hologram of Princess Leia? Bzz. This princess is literally a little tiny princess in a box. Yeah, that magician shrunk her down. Tried to keep her captive, and then Sinbad got a hold of her. Oh, she gonna, look at that. Look at this giant. Oh, look at that costume. I'm getting distracted. Yeah, look at, oh, it's a real giant thing she's got to push. Oh, wow. I cannot watch how they talk. Gotta do it, damn it. Just do it. If you want to save your own cute little butt. Oh no. Oh shit. There he goes, that weird walk. Look at that awesome shading. All right, he's gone. Ah, he wants the lamp. She got it on a roll. There it is. oh, don't push her over. That's what I used to think. He doesn't even check. Are you off the platform? Pooh! They're all fucked up. Like me. Oh no, here he comes. He's all roasted. I don't know if he's gonna make it. There you go. Yeah, go. You can see how these are composites because the colors change. There's probably two or three different layers in this. Whoa! Got him in the back. Oh, shit. Oh, it's got a great profile, I'll tell you that. Go, man. Oh, shit. He's after him. Can't free the guy yet. Oh, yeah. Pull a tree out. Oh! Whoo! That guy just got out. My hair's sticking out. Oh, look at that. Just one squash. Oh! He's got the lamp. And I assume he's got the princess. Didn't see it, but... Oh, look at that. He got right down there. Great face. Look at that. I love the animation. Harryhausen always had a real dramatic... I mean, he spent time on these things, man. So he would... They would be very dramatic. There, get that guy off there. Look at that. Oh! And look how much... God. I can't imagine the hours, days... spent animating this stuff. He's blind. Oh, shit. Poke his ass. Uh-oh. Feel the heat? He's blind. And the thing about this is... This was the second Cyclops, I believe, in the movie. There was, I think, one just before this scene... And there's another, a third one coming up towards the end. So there's actually like three Cyclops because it says the land of the Cyclops. Not one guy, but many of them. There he goes. And then here's a still. Yeah. Aww. But I think, and I think in... Well, like this one, he got stabbed in the back. I think Harryhausen had just used the same Cyclops for all three of them. But he probably knew when he was going to have to puncture him. So he probably used, okay, this one is for this puncture. This one is for the front puncture, back puncture, or whatever. Oh, the lamp, yeah. He's like, I got it, it's mine. Yeah, Sinbad. Oh, look at this. I remember me and some friends did a trek to up. Oh shit! Look at that! Whoa! A place called the Bridge to Nowhere, up somewhere in the San Bernardino Mountains or something. Bridge to Nowhere, California. Look it up. We had to walk a thing like this. It was even thinner, I feel, and steeper. Oh, no. Oh, shit. He couldn't make it. So there you go. That's the clip, man. Yeah, let's stop here. All right. The Seventh Voyage of Sinbad. The best part, the Cyclops. In any part of the movie. The end, the beginning, the middle, the Cyclops is, he's the man. And, yeah, I just love the animation, classic stuff. Look, just as a kid, one of my favorite movies of all time. So hopefully, you'll get to see what I show you, and then I'll lead you to the link, which is a few years old, so it should be okay. But yeah, so, well, thanks for watching again, and one more episode to go, and then I need a break. But it's all right. I'll make sure. I'm going to try to do something, good for the last one, and I think I'm going to go back to a first real movie for the last one, so we'll revisit something and see the best part of that. Which one? I don't know. I've got several in my head. I have one in particular that I want to do, but could change at the last minute. And that'll probably be in another 2 weeks. I want to try to get it in on the last day of June because I want to try to get at least two in a month. If that doesn't happen, it'll be the 1st of July or 2nd or something. Definitely before the 4th. So we'll see you before the 4th. And again, click below for the link to the movie and enjoy it. And thanks for the ride, man. Take care.
Tarquin fim tim lim bim wim bim lim stuff tang for tang ole biscuit barrel. Party.